Okay, we got another one. This is Yusuf Estes. We're here on the mailbox answering questions as fast as they come in. We got a question here right now coming to us. This is from a non-Muslim, and he's asking, okay, this is related to the same one too. All right, it says, inheritance. How come in Islam the Muslims do not inherit anything from somebody that's not Muslim and vice versa? Is the U.S. law better to decide? Okay, you got a couple of questions mixed together. Let's try to straighten it out. First of all, what is inheritance? When someone passes away, when they die, there is a will. In Islam, it is mandatory for every Muslim to leave a will. And the will tells people what to do with whatever estate that they may still have. So this is the distribution of wealth right away, saying to give this and to give that and so on. Now, according to some of the scholars, they say that the inheritance from outside of Islam cannot come to the Muslims. In other words, if your mother or father, somebody like this, was not Muslim, they died, then you could not inherit from them. So another opinion is that you could, and vice versa, meaning that also that non-Muslims might inherit from Muslims. Regardless of which of these arguments you decide to listen to, and whichever seems the strongest, regardless of this, I would like to give myself and all of us some advice. I like to listen to the scholars who spend a lot of time on a particular subject. I don't want to go to someone who spends most of his time dealing with how to recite the Quran, and then I ask him about a hadith, or I ask him about a ruling on something like this, because if I do, he's liable to say something he heard one time but not really understand the research that goes along with it. Now, in this case, when we talk about inheritance and you ask something about the United States law, I will tell you that it's very important for you to have a will. Even if you're not a Muslim and you're watching our show right now, please do this for the benefit of your own children and your own peace of mind, because if you die intestate, that means you die without a will, then the state will take over and there will be some probate that will be involved, and then it's up to the court to decide who gets what, and there's going to be a certain amount of the wealth that will be basically taken by the government before it ever gets distributed, and that's still going to be down the road over a period of time. So the best thing for all of us to do, regardless if you're Muslim or not Muslim, do have a will. Go to an attorney or someone you trust that knows the law and ask them how to put it together. If you're a Muslim, you know that we have these available at any mosque or Islamic center to help you be able to put together this will. Then you can specify who will receive what according to Islam and so on. As far as the non-Muslim receiving or not receiving, if you put it in your will that you want somebody to have something, that's good. One final point is, if you're having a lot of wealth, you can also distribute it before you die and put it in a trust. Talk to an attorney about that, and then you can avoid probate altogether. And that's wrapping it up for this question. That was pretty in-depth, I think. And I think it's also important to mention, by the way, we are not giving any legal advice to anybody. And check, by the way, our website for more videos like this at www.islammailbox.com. Until next time, this is Yusuf Estes wishing you peace. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.